Historically, acute gastroenteritis in young children was a very common and very lethal disease.
The estimates were that there were 5 million children dying a year from diarrheal diseases, and we did not have a clue of what was causing this disease.
This discovery is probably the most important Australian contribution to child health.
The Royal Children's Hospital is on record at the turn of the 20th century as having given instructions to clinicians not to admit children who with acute gastroenteritis because there was no form of treatment that they could use. So presumably they just went home and many of them died. Slowly over the years, the clinicians realised that there was treatment, which was replacement of fluid and electrolytes, but there remained a large group, particularly in very young children, who were often involved in widespread epidemics. It was very dangerous. It could kill even healthy children in our society. And nobody knew what caused it.
Louis Pasteur said that chance favors the prepared mind. Here you have a woman, an investigator, who was looking for a dozen years since she finished her PhD for bacteria and all sorts of clinical specimens, trying to find this specimen that could be linked to a disease, to this disease.
Well, Ruth, let's have a look at this photo because this takes us back to the 70s.
Many children arrived looking like that.
Dr. Townley was the director of gastroenterology at that time.
I serendipitously found myself invited into a project which Dr. Townley and Ruth Bishop had designed. For about 2 years we worked together using the new technique of small intestinal biopsy. Dr. Townley modified the capsule.
And he did it by a clever mechanism of adapting the little capsule to sit onto cardiac catheter, which meant you could push it down gently and it was all over in 5 minutes.
We looked at about 30 children and we found that they had severe inflammation in the duodenum.
It didn't result in an answer to the puzzle of what was causing this.
But the finding of the site of the lesion was critical to finding out the cause.
Ruth was not a virologist. She was not an electron microscopist. She was not a pediatrician. But she was unsuccessful in finding bacterial agents that might account for this. She had been looking for 12 years.
What I did was to decide that it was worth going back, but using an electron microscope.
The electron microscope was new to looking at viruses, and many people were looking, but no one had found something that was linked.
Jeff Davidson, who was the next research fellow, was persuaded to do a few more biopsies, and they did 9 more and sent them over to Ian Holmes.
Ian handed it over to one of his laboratory assistants, Brian Ruck. According to him, he couldn't see anything, and he called out a colleague, Roger Snagel, had a look and said, "You've got an orbivirus there." And that was that. I can't remember clearly, but I think I put the phone down and went racing along the corridor to tell anybody I could find. We found it.
You know, in science, priority goes to the first person to discover something. If you're the second or third, and after she made this discovery, all the electron microscopy community looked, and it was there around the world. And that's where Ruth, quote, she was so surprised because it was just a publication in The Lancet. But the response to that publication was epidemic.
Serendipity had a large role to play in this.
There's a lot of serendipity, sure, But it's also a focused serendipity. She got the right people together. She was able to get the right specimen and the right electron microscopist and pool resources. And it's the teamwork that's really been characteristic of so many advances in science.
Not only did Ruth make the early discovery of rotavirus, but about 10 years later, she reported data that has really led the entire rotavirus vaccine development. And that data from Royal Children's Hospital was that children that got infected very, very young were then actually protected. Ruth and her team have tried to develop that vaccine. It's called RV3.
And that's where the work continues here at the Children's Hospital at the University of Melbourne and MCRI, based on that early observation of that very unusual, unique strain of rotavirus RV3, was how could we develop this to a vaccine to really target children from birth. And that's a very unique strategy. It's a very unique vaccine, and it's a vaccine that's been developed here, a homegrown vaccine from Melbourne and from this campus, which we're very proud of.
We're assembled here in Melbourne because this is really the home of rotavirus. This is where the virus was discovered by Ruth Bishop and the group at the Royal Children's Hospital.
We bring experts on rotavirus disease from around the world every 2 years, and we talk about the latest discoveries. And we're particularly excited that Ruth Bishop is here to actually meet with Ruth and to honor her here at this event.
Ruth, did you ever imagine we'd have 350 scientists from 54 countries all excited to be here, diligently following up on the consequences of your discovery 43 years ago? It seems absolutely incredible.
The fact that it was a woman who had such a major discovery was a really big deal for women scientists. I was a woman building a lab, and I was hiring only women. And when we went to a rotavirus meeting and Ruth was there at the meeting, the only thing they wanted out of the meeting was to get a picture with her, because they said, this kind of validates what we are doing.
Ruth Bishop's discovery was really pivotal to all the work that we're doing today. I mean, without the rotavirus, discovery of the rotavirus, you know, we wouldn't have the vaccine and we wouldn't be saving lives. And especially in South Africa, we've seen a huge impact.
So her work has had impact not only here in Australia, but all around the world. And millions of children will live because of her legacy.
Think about Ruth's career. She was 12 years playing with bacteria, trying to find a cause of some of these diseases without much success. And bingo, in a short period of time, with one biopsy and one electron microscopist, they made a discovery that is still having repercussions today. And I think the joy of science is that bingo and seeing the consequences of that discovery.
You know, I would go as far as to say that this discovery is probably the most important Australian contribution to child health.
It was so sort of satisfying to solve a puzzle. You can't really imagine what it's like until it's happened to you, and I was fortunate it's happened to me at least once in my career.